हेलो, अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल। आई एम मिस्टर एसएस साजने फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, शरद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, पॉलिटेक्निक, एंड आई एम टीचिंग द सब्जेक्ट मैनेजमेंट। एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड विद द एमसीक्यूज फ्रॉम अ प्रीवियस लेक्चर, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद द सेम चैप्टर, एंड नाउ लेट्स सी सम फ्यू मोर क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द सेकेंड चैप्टर। In the previous lecture, we have covered almost 10 questions. So we will continue with our 11th question. So the question is, following is a financial statement prepared and approved prior to a defined period of time. And the options are, option A, audit, option B, control charts, option C, budget, and option D, order of payment. If we speak about audit, then we already know that though audit it is concerned with or related with finance, but it is never prepared or approved prior to any activity. So usually audit is a post-activity process. So option A will be wrong. If we consider the second option, that is control charts, then it is a graph used to study how a process changes over time. So again, this will be not related with the financial statement. Then again, if we consider the last option, that is order of payment, which is nothing but a document ordering the payment of money drawn by one person or bank to the other, and thus it is also a post activity process. So the answer for this question is option C, that is budget. So budget is a financial statement prepared and approved prior to a defined period of time. Now the next question, dash means forecasting and pre-planning with a reference to finance, and the options are option A, budget, option B, audit, option C is control, and option D is inspection. So all these terms we have already discussed, just the question is asked in different wordings. So you might be knowing this answer. So the answer for this question is nothing but again budget, that is option A. Again, the next question, following is not the information needed for planning at supervisory level, and the options are option A, number of jobs to be done, option B, time expectation, option C, profile margin, and option D, sequence of operations. So for this question, we can refer to the point, that is planning at supervisory level, where we have studied that during the planning, the supervisor has to deal with all the resources, such as full use of human resources, employee work schedules, material planning or machine utilization. So if we look at the given options, then we can see that the first option, that is number of jobs to be done, that is necessary for planning. Then again, option C and D, that option B and D, that is time expectation and sequence of operations, these are also the part of planning at supervisory level. The only option that stands out is option C, that is profile margin, which is nothing but the measure of profitability. So this profit margin is the concept which is related with the top level or mid level management. And since in the question they have asked for supervisory level, we can say that option C is our answer for this question. Except profile margin, all the other options, that is number of jobs to be done, time expectation and sequence of operations, all these information are needed for planning at supervisory level. Now the next question, following is not done in planning by supervisor. The options are given below. Option A, selection of machines. Option B, assigning workers. Option C, allocate time for operation. And option D, marketing of products. So again, this is similar type of question which we have just seen now. If we look at the option A, B and C, then selection of machines, assigning workers and allocate time for operation, all these work is related with the resources which is to be done by the supervisor while planning. Whereas option D, that is marketing of products, for this purpose we are having a separate department, that is the marketing department. So this marketing department will look regarding the selling of these products and making the customers aware regarding the products which are manufactured. So the answer for this question, as this is a negative type of question, they have asked which is not done in planning by supervisor. So the answer for this question will be option D, that is marketing of products, which is not a part of planning by supervisor. Now the next question is, what are the important information to supervisor while planning? And the options are, option A, quantity of jobs, option B, delivery time, option C, quality standards, and option D, all of the above. So whenever the supervisor is planning, then he requires certain information such as how much quantity of jobs are to be manufactured. So for example, if he has to manufacture 10,000 jobs or say 1 lakh jobs, then whether he is having that much amount of material, or whether that machines are capable for performing the task, as well as the whatever the jobs are to be manufactured, he should also know that at what time these products or the manufactured jobs has to be delivered. And again, he should also know regarding what quality standards are to be maintained. So after having all these information, the supervisor will be then able to prepare his plan. So in this question, they have asked that what information is necessary. So whatever the options they have given, that is option A, quantity of goods or jobs, and then again delivery time and quality standards, all these are very much necessary while planning. So the answer for this question is option D, that is all. Our next question is given here. While selecting machines, what kind of information is not necessary to the supervisor? So again, this is a negative type of question. They have asked what information is not necessary for the supervisor. So the options are, option A, total machines, option B, cycle time, option C, operations required, and option D, maintenance standard. So for this question, I would like to remind you that in one of our lectures, we have seen the what are the guidelines for selecting machines by the supervisor. So in that we have studied that the supervisor will first determine what task is to be carried out. So depending on the given task, he will first get idea regarding what operations are to be carried out. So he will also see what are the total machines available for the completion of that task. Then he will also get the idea of cycle time and productivity parameters of the machine. And thus, if we look at the given options, then from this we can say that the first three options, that is total machine, cycle time and operations required, these are the necessary information for the supervisor. But since in the question they have asked which information is not required or not necessary for the supervisor, so we can say that the answer for this question will be option D, that is maintenance standard. So a maintenance standard is actually the concept which is related with the methods to perform several tasks such as cleaning, lubrication or repair works. So all such kind of work are to be done separately, and when we are selecting the machines, we cannot interfere it with the maintenance standards. Now let's see the next question. So the question is, while allotting work to workers, what information is not important. And the options are option A, qualification, option B, skills, option C is the abilities, and option D is specialties. So from the given options, we are supposed to select the option which is not important for allotting work to the workers. So if we consider the first option, that is qualification, then this is the answer to this question only, because nowadays we know that most of the students are having good qualification, but they might not be having the practical knowledge for performing that given task. So thus, while allotting the work to the workers, it is necessary to observe that the candidate or the worker is having enough skills, or he is having good ability to perform that given task, or whether he is having some special skills so that he can complete the work in minimum time. So the option B, C and D, all these options are necessary for allotting work, but since in the question they have asked what information is not important, so the answer for this question is option A, that is qualification. Now again, the next question is, in this question they have given two statements related with planning, and we have to select or we have to consider which of the given statements are correct or incorrect. So the question is, in planning, the first statement, rescheduling must not be avoided, and the second statement is, if needed, do rescheduling. And the options given for this question are, option A, only one is correct, option B, only two correct, option C, both the given statements are correct, and option D, both given statements are wrong. So if we look at the question properly, then as they have given the two statements, rescheduling must not be avoided, and the second option is, if needed, do rescheduling. So we have to just understand this, whether these both statements are either correct or incorrect, and then we will select the right option. So for this question, you can take a reference of the point, that is limitations of planning by supervisor, where we have seen that there are certain limitations while planning, that is say if there is any kind of change in technology, then whatever the planning has been done, that can fail. Also the planning is generally done for the future, so as the things in future, we cannot predict it very perfectly, so there are chances that there might be need of changing the plan, and this is nothing but we call it as a rescheduling. So at many places we have to change our plan, that is a rescheduling is must. So in the given question, whatever the two statements they have given, that is rescheduling must not be avoided, and if needed, do rescheduling, both these statements are correct, and thus the answer for this question is option C, that is both the options are correct. Now the next question, that is 19th question, while planning, which parameters does supervisor observe? And the options are, option A, manpower, option B, schedule, option C, oversight, and option D, all. So for planning, the supervisor has to determine that how many players he will require, as well as what skills each player is having, so that the project can be completed in time. Then again, if we speak about scheduling, then it is also necessary, as the supervisor always has to set a schedule based on whatever are the production requirements. Then again, oversight, good supervisor always knows that where his project stands at any time, so he performs an oversight role along with the responsibility to ensure that quality standards are obtained. So the answer for this question is option D, that is all. Now the next question, we are having here two statements. The first statement, That is, a supervisor makes short-term planning. And the second given statement is, managers make long-term planning. The options that are given for this question is, option A, only one is correct. Option B, only two is correct. Option C, both are incorrect. And option D, both given options are correct. So first we have to consider that whatever the two statements they have given, whether they are correct or incorrect individually, and then we will go for the options. So if we consider the first part of the statement, that is, the supervisor makes short-term planning, then yes, it is exactly true, because we have seen that the supervisor is to deal with the daily activities. So right from the beginning of the shift, during the shift and after the shift, he has to work. So he will he's working on the short-term planning. Whereas if we see the second part of the statement, that is, managers make long-term planning, then this statement is also true. So now, since we are now knowing that the statement 1 and statement 2 both are correct, so if we now look at the options, then directly we will get the answer. So the answer for this question is option D, that is, both the statements are correct. The next question: securing raw material from stores is the responsibility of dash. So the options are, option A, supervisor. Option B, line manager. Option C, purchase manager. And option D, materials manager. For this question, many times the students would write the answer for this question as option D, that is, materials manager. But if you are selecting this option, then you will be wrong, because material manager, this option would have been right if they have asked in the question that you are securing the raw material from outside. So but in the question they have given that we are securing the raw material from stores. That is, the material is already available inside the workshop. So since we are not purchasing or taking the raw material from outside, the option that is the materials manager will be incorrect. Then again, if we speak about option C, that is, purchase manager, then his role is limited to either go for that purchase or not. So option C will be also incorrect. If we see option B, that is, line manager, then the function of line manager is to manage the other employees. So that option will be also incorrect. And so the correct answer for this question is option A, that is, supervisor. So supervisor is the person who will be securing the raw material from stores. Now next question is, supervisor is dash focused in planning. And the options are, option A, completely. Option B, internally. Option C is externally. And option D is none of the above. So for this question, I think that there is not much need to discuss on this question, because we have seen one difference between the supervisory planning and managerial planning, and in that part we have already studied regarding this point. So supervisor is the person concerned with lower level management, and he is totally focused internally in planning. Whereas if in the question it was asked related to manager, then the managers who are from the mid level or top level management, so they are focused externally in planning. But for now, since in the question we are having supervisor, so the answer for this question will be option B, that is, internally focused in planning. The next question: supervisor plans budget on dash expenses and manager plans budget on dash expenses. Now again, we can take reference of the same point, that is, difference between supervisory and managerial planning. And in that, we have seen that the supervisor will plan budget on smaller expenses, whereas the manager will plan budget on larger expenses. Thus, the correct option for this question is option A, that is small and large. Now again, the next question. What is the upward correct chronology? They have given 6 points, that is, first is worker, second is foreman, third is supervisor, fourth is manager, fifth is shift in charge, and sixth is helper. So in this question, we have to arrange all these 6 points in such a way that we are having upward correct chronology. This means that we are supposed to arrange all these people in such a way that the people who are having a high status or a higher responsibility and authority, those are to be placed at the top position, whereas the person who is having minimum authority and responsibility, those persons are to be placed at the bottom. So in this way, we are going to arrange all these 6 points. So I will directly tell the answer for this question, and the correct answer is option C. So we'll see this at the bottom place. First we will be having helper, then above helper we will be having worker, then again above worker we will be having foreman, above foreman we will be having supervisor, and above supervisor we will be having shift in charge, and at the top we will be having manager. So out of all given options, the option C is having correct upward chronology. Next question, that is 25th one. Safe working condition is the responsibility of Dash. So in this question, they have given again 6 people. You have to answer which of the following given people will be having a responsibility related to safe working conditions. So they have given the names as follows. First is the worker, second is supplier, third is the supervisor, fourth is manager, fifth is factory head, and sixth one is customer. So out of all these 6 people, we have to choose such people who will be having the responsibility related to safe working condition. So the options given are 2, 3, 4, and 6. That is, we will relate this with the given options. So if we consider the first option, that is 2, 3, 4, 6, which means that supplier, supervisor, manager, and sixth one was a customer. So now we have to think that whether these 4 people are having the responsibility of safe working condition, and if not, then we will move to the next option. So likewise, if you compare all the options with the given conditions regarding the responsibility of safe working condition, then you will be getting the answer. So I will directly give you the answer. Option D, that is 1, 3, 4 and 5, these are the people who are having the responsibility of safe working condition. So as per option D, first one is nothing but worker, option 3 is supervisor, option 4 is the manager, and option 5 is the factory head. So we are excluding the supplier and customer from our options. So the remaining people will be having this responsibility related to a safe working condition. So that's all for today. We'll stop here, and let's continue with the remaining MCQs in the next lecture. So thank you very much.